And here we are with the Intercontinental Championship match. And here's our Intercontinental Champion, Azzy. Azzy won that title at Survivor Series by defeating Batista. Now he's going to come here at WrestleMania against his brother. The brother who defeated him and took his WWE World Championship at TLC Year 3. And now 15 months later, after one failed attempt to get his title back, he's going to WrestleMania as Intercontinental Champion. The first time ever. This is the first time ever. Ozzy has came into WrestleMania as champion. Wait, wrong. He came to WrestleMania Year 2 as champion when he defeated Sally. No, Sally defeated him. Sorry, people. And there he is right here in Los Angeles. Ozzy. He said he's learned from mistakes that he had made in his first time around being in his company. Now he's going to build on the mistakes and make a correction. He's Ozzy 2.0. And that title right there, he said, made him who he is. And if it didn't make him, then he would not be here. And here is his brother, his full blood brother, not half, full blood. SuperNova. And here they are. DC, the brothers, they're going to battle it out here at WrestleMania Year 5 at an Intercontinental Championship. SuperNova didn't take his opportunities as number one contender to fight his brother for an Intercontinental Championship because he wanted his brother to forgive him. His brother didn't do that. So he said, in the next 30 days, I get to have my championship match anytime I want. And what time is more perfect than now here at And he told us all, this time, Abel will kill Cain. And no, Abel's not jealous like Cain was. Abel's just fed up of all the dumb bullshit that goes around in their family because of one man who just wants to be the man but can't let his brother be the man too. But tonight, who's going to win? It's the big question. As Ozzy versus SuperNova 3 is here at WrestleMania Year 5. Here goes Ozzy with a flying forearm. So, Ozzy said he learned from his mistakes, but his first time around, before he said that after SummerSlam Year 4, he was one of the best. Three-time WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Tag Team Champion, Intercontinental Champion. Not only that, in November during Year 1, he was the only man ever to be Tag Team Singles and World Champion on the same brand at the same time. In the same month, and he held that for just 1 month because the next month in December he ended up losing the tag team titles and Intercontinental title at the same pay-per-view. It was a little bit too much for him. He had to wrestle too much in one pay-per-view. And here comes Sally, Ozzy with a Blue Thunder Bob already. Is it over already? No. SuperNova kicks out. I don't know why I said Sally. I'm getting a little bit too hype about that streak versus streak match later tonight. There goes a kick into the gut, and then a strong DDT by SuperNova. He's a little bit pissed. And since this is a brother versus brother match, like WWA, this is no holds barred. They could do anything they want. Blood versus. Ooh, smack the Ozzy by SuperNova. Suplex. SuperNova, you can tell he's a little bit pissed. He's been wanting to do this for a long time since his brother ignored him and, you know, avoided him, he says. But Azzy says he didn't avoid him. He was just going a different path. Kick right into Ozzy's face. He was just going a separate path, and he just didn't want to look at the other path because he didn't believe the other path was a good path to be going on. And there, uh-oh, Azzy. Oh, my God. With an Azzy slam. One, two. No, SuperNova kicks out. And Ozzy's coming out strong with these finishers quick. And there he goes, with Azzy. Oh, whoa. Blood. This is how you know they do not like each other right now. They do not. Here comes SuperNova with another suplex. Come on, SuperNova. You got to do something more. I think. Oh, a fail drop kick. And there goes. Ooh, kick right into the face of Azzy by SuperNova. Here we go. Power slam right into the mat. It's concrete under there. Those mats just prevent scrapes, not pain. Now he has a kendo stick. And he missed twice. Oh, there goes a kick into the face. SuperNova wants Azzy to bleed this time. That's what he wants to happen. You make me bleed, I'm going to make you bleed, you son of a bitch. So he's going to go for a vertical suplex right into the steel steps. If he did that, oh my lord. But now Azzy throws him into the steel steps. Pretty smart. Alright, what is Azzy going to do right here? Alright, Azzy Green. And he missed. What was that? Oh, right into the ground. Uh-oh. Azzy right onto the ground. Bam! There we go. Will Azzy be leaving here as Intercontinental Champion? As it's like every other year he comes out as champion. Year two. Oh, no. Year two, then year three, he did come out as champion. That's true. This will make him 3-1 at WrestleMania. As he won a year two, he won a year three, lost last year. And year three, it looks like he's going to win as he's been dominant against his younger brother, the brother who beat him twice. Once at TLC, where his brother won the title, and twice at Over the Limit, where his brother defended his title against him. And there goes Azzy. Azzy's out of gas, people. And he's going to get the cover. With the arm slightly on his brother. And he rolls over. He gets up. He said, no. He's like, no, this is not over. No, that's too easy. That's too easy for Azzy. He gets up. And he goes for Azzy slam. I know he's trying to injure his brother, the brother who took everything away from him. Everything to him. That title was everything to him. And for him, No, Super Life was like, hell no. We're going to fight this with our fucking fist. And there goes a kick. Oh, shit. There goes a left eye kick. Here we go for the pinfall. There goes Azzy with an immediate kick out. Holy shit. And there goes, no, he misses the chair shot. And then he gets him with the chair shot now. And he throws the chair onto Azzy. And there, oh my God. Here we go. And then he gets a flying forearm to slow down the momentum. But SuperNova's not done. He gets right up from that near. He trips Azzy. Uh-oh. Oh my God. With some punches. And here we go. Monster. I think it's over. SuperNova's going to start kicking him. Uh-oh. We have not seen this ever. Flying SuperNova. The star has been flying. And he's about to go for the pinfall, I think. Will he go for the pinfall? No! Azzy gets out the ring! He gets out the ring. Perfect time. By the... Uh-oh. SuperNova is pissed. No chairs. None of that. Fist. Izzy's going to pick him up. What is Izzy going to do? He's going for a power slam again. Bam! This is awesome. These two brothers are back. I guess them family reunions are very special because they both want to go home with the gold. And there goes the Izzy. Uh-oh. What is he doing? Shit! SuperNova, get the pin! Get the pin! Here we go! And he, SuperNova wins! SuperNova is now five-time United States champion as he defeats his brother for the third time! That came out of nowhere, and that is his best finisher ever. And Azzy could have won it there. He could have won it another time. But he wanted to do more. He wanted to damage his brother. But right there, he could have taken home. He told us he was not going to make the mistakes he made before. But right there, he did. And SuperNova. SuperNova, the left eye kick is strong. But when he pushes you in the air and kick you while you're in the air, that left eye kick becomes a SuperNova left eye kick. And here's what he has deserved. Oh, and my apologies, people. I meant this is his first time winning the Intercontinental Championship. That's how you know he was a good United States champion, because if this was a United States Championship match, he would be a five-time United States champion. And here he is. Fight Kevin Owens. And they're going to fight in a tables match. As the stipulations at WrestleMania, we tell you at the last minute as a surprise, unlike other wrestling promotions. But Kevin Owens and Brock Lesnar are fighting for the management of Paul Heyman, because Paul Heyman is not allowed to manage both of these men, because he only like favors one or the other at certain points of the year. And they don't like that. They just want him to favor one. Okay. Whoa. Michael Cole and JBL just ran. I guess, you know, they're not going to announce tonight for their, fans. But here comes Brock Lesnar. Suplex time. As he lost at Royal Rumble against CM Punk for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. And then he lost at Royal Rumble as he was entrant number 30 to MoneyGuy. Will he come here? Will he keep his manager by beating the fucking shit out of Kevin Owens? We don't know. But we have another resident. And here comes Brock Lesnar with a quick clothesline. This is a tables match. There's no pinfall. There's no submission. There's no countouts. There's none of that. Just put your opponent through a table. And whoever wins this match gets the management of Paul Heyman. Paul Kevin Owens once when he asked him to work with Brock Lesnar. And he did. And after Kevin Owens lost, he spent more time focusing on Brock Lesnar. He even made it seem like he wasn't managing Kevin Owens by saying that whoever wins this match at TLC will face my client Brock Lesnar at Royal Rumble. And that TLC match had Kevin Owens versus CM Punk. But because he knows that Paul Heyman is the greatest manager of all time. And Kevin Owens is like, you know, he doesn't even need a manager. But having Paul Heyman, it just, you know, it works. And there goes Brock, as Brock at first was not even doing that much, but now Kevin Owens is getting that momentum back Because Kevin Owens knows you have to slay the beast. First, you do all you want to him. And he said, the beast is not going to be slayed this time. He's going to be buried. I'm tired of everybody slaying the beast. Uh-oh. Powerbomb right. Oh, it was close to being on the table, but holy shit, Brock. Oh, he's scooting him back into the table. And he said, nuh-uh, I want to get this done. Back hitting on the table. This is a flat table. That hurts a lot worse than going through a table because the metal. Uh-oh. Here comes Brock. Will he get triple power bombs onto the table? No, but he still gets one. He gets a two. Gets a three. He gets a third power bomb on Kevin Owens. And Brock said he's gonna beat Kevin Owens' ass like Madea, Keith Palmer, in one of those Tyler Perry movies. Which, if we look back, she beat the shit out of him. There goes a clothesline by Brock Lesnar. And there's a sign in the back that I'm a Heyman guy. Do you want to join this match? Brock Lesnar is trying to end this match immediately. Oh, that was close. It doesn't matter if it's just his leg, his foot. If that goes through a table and that table breaks, it is over for Brock and it's over for his relationship with Paul Heyman. And there goes a slap onto the... Uh-oh. No, he misses that. Here we go! F. Click the button. It's F5. Brock Lesnar gets the first F5. Uh-oh. Kevin Owens gets a backbreaker, and he's taking the table off the turnbuckle. What he's going to do with that table? He's just standing there now. And he breaks the table immediately. Clothesline again. Oh, damn. He's going to break Kevin Owens' spine. Talk all that shit. That's what the fuck happens. He's going to body slam him on the edge of that table. He's going to break Kevin Owens' back. I was going to say, Brock doesn't need a weapon. His hands are freaking weapons. He just used the table. That's true. Oh. Brock Lesnar was suplex number one. Suplex number two. Brock Kevin Owens through Suplex City first before he does anything else, it looks like to me. He's going to let Kevin Owens get back up so he can get ready for another super. Uh-oh, Kevin Owens with another backbreaker. Brock Lesnar showing off why he's a beast. Suplex number three. Oh, he's losing all his energy from doing that. All I gotta say is Brock and Kevin, this is WrestleMania. You guys are not, you know, we thought these two would be gladiators. Something out right now. They're not even doing that much. I think Brock's warming up or he's injured or something. He said he was at 100% this time. But oh, here comes Brock with a suplex number four. I think Brock is actually, you know, he's probably like taking it slow, and then he's just going to freaking beat the shit out of Kevin. But Kevin does slow down the momentum a lot. But Kevin, you got to We need to see some blood. We need to see you guys battling it out. This is not okay. And there goes Kevin Owens breaking Brock Lesnar's back. He's going to destroy his back. They're trying to destroy each other's backs. They want to be paralyzed. They said they're trying to kill each other. And there goes suplex number 5 onto the table. What is Brock doing? What are they doing? I don't even think they want to fight each other. I think they both want to be managed by Paul Heyman. Suplex number 6. Uh-oh, they're taking it. We need a better camera view. We're being blocked off. What is Kevin going to do? Reverses that. I'm so confused by this match. Like, I thought that Brock and Kevin, you know, come out destroying each other, but it's not really happening. It seems like it's like they barely want to hit each other. Wait a minute. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. KO gets the KO. Knocking. Look at that. Look at this. One more time. Bam. Right into the table. Nah, something's. All I got to say is, fans, get ready for Raw after WrestleMania because we need answers. That did not seem right. For some reason, it seemed like Kevin Owens and Brock Lesnar didn't want to fight each other throughout the whole match. As Kevin Owens gets the Paul Heyman contract, Paul Heyman might have something up his sleeves. And there he is. There he is. The greatest of all time in the WWA. He wrestled in the WWG. He wrestled in the WWA. He didn't leave for RMW. His name is Sally. Sally has not had a WWE match in 3 years. Since year 2. Like, oh my god. So Sally is 12-0 at WrestleMania, and now he's going to go against DRIII, who is 199-0 in singles competition. The match since his debut. Never, ever. He has defeated many great people, except Sally and MoneyGuy, too, which we called him out. We told him at Survivor Series he needs to go against Money Guy. Never done it. But now, tonight, he's going against Sal. Here's our WWA Undisputed DRIII. He's from New York. Got that damn right. He's from the East Coast. And he's on the West Coast right now in Los Angeles. This is our secondary main event. As he is 199-0. Last year he defeated Doggy. He has on his waist. He went to SummerSlam to defeat Azzy. He went to Survivor Series to defeat Diamond Dallas Page. And now he is here at WrestleMania once again. And can he defeat Sally? Sally is 12-0 at WrestleMania. Sally at WrestleMania, he does not play. So will DRIII be able to come out of this one? Done it before in every match he has ever had in the WWA. and the fans, here we go! Sally, 12-0 at WrestleMania. DRIII, 199-0 in singles competitions. This is day for the Undisputed Championship in their streets. And Sally with a jab right to DRIII and kicks him again. These two men are, I can't even say the word. They're amazing. They're better than amazing. And they're, oh, he's trying to go for an uppercut. He misses the uppercut in DRIII. No, and then he reverses that. Sally has been undefeated at WrestleMania since 2000. And he beat the light. In this series, he has beat the likes of The Undertaker, Azzy, and Kevin Owens. And he beat Kevin Owens for the Intercontinental Championship. He beat Azzy for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. He beat Undertaker. And now he's going to try to beat DRIII for the WWE Undisputed Championship. He has won 3 out of 4 championships in the WWE in this series. And Sally's coming out swinging with a DDT. With another DDT. Sally actually lost his Intercontinental Championship at WWE Money in the Bank Year 3 to DRIII. And that's when DRIII debuted. DRIII debuted in that year, I mean. He debuted at Extreme Rules Year 3. He defeated Silva. Oh! Now DRIII's getting mad. He defeated Silva in that match. That was his debut. And ever since then, he has not been defeated at all. And as soon as he hits the old school, it's over. Sometimes he doesn't even have to do the cash drop. He chooses what he wants. And it's over. And it's kicked out of the cash drop. Or old school. Sally was one. Here we go. Oh. Hold on, let me fix my damn eyes right quick. I don't believe I just saw. Sally kicked out of the old school? The hell? And now Sally's going for. Will he get it? 1, 2. No. He gets up. DRIII gets up. And there goes the DDT by Sally. Now he's kicking him in the chest. I can't even get riled up by that. I was surprised. DRIII has won so many matches, as we know, because he's in 199-0. With the old school. And Sally is the first man to kick out of that. Now he throws him to the side. And now he does that. Sally gets an elbow drop right into DR3's chest. Now DR3's going to punch him right. Is he going for the... No, he's going for the bionic elbow. Doop-de-doop-de-doop. Bow! Right into the damn head of Sally. Now he's going for the pinfall. Two, oh no! Kicks out! Kick out by Sally. And he also beat a lot of people with the bionic elbow. This is amazing. Wow. And Sally was the first man he ever defeated for his championship in a championship match. As he only has been in he's been in plenty, obviously. He's undefeated. But what I mean is, like, as the challenger. He's only been in 2 matches as challenger for a title. And the first one was against Sally. Which was freaking good. But will this be even better? Now Sally gets thrown into the turnbuckle and clothesline with a strong clothesline by DRIII. Now DRIII is kicking him in his abdomen. Uh-oh. No! We thought he was going for another cash drop or another... Oh, God. Kick right back into his face. We thought he was going for another old school, but he didn't get to do it because Sally's... ...minute now. And another clothesline into Sally. And now, ooh, he misses the cross body. Right into his back. He's trying to break DR3's back. Now he's going to watch him crawl. He's going to watch him slowly grab those ropes. Slowly get up. Sally's going up for the kick. Now he's going for the choke slam. The fans are going crazy. Tombstone. Sally picks up DRIII. What is he going to do? DRIII reverses that. Hits him. Oh, come on, Sally. No. Why did they do this? Just take the pin. Now here we go with an old school number two. This may be it for Sally. The streak of years. The streak, the hard work he's done at WrestleMania could be over. Here we go with the pinfall. One. Two. He kicks out. Sally kicks out. Here we go. DRIII, is he going for the cash drop? No, he didn't get it. He didn't get it. Sally for the tombstone. Sally's going for the tombstone. Go, he got him. He got him. Get the pin. Get the fucking pin. One, two, and DRIII is not going to let that happen. No way. Sally got up? What is with these people? Get the freaking win. And Sally's getting outside the ring now. He said, meet me outside. Outside, what for? Oh, right into the freaking mat. That mat only protects you from scars. It doesn't protect you from pain. That was a hard one. And now DRIII throws, is he going to punch him right into his fucking jaw? One, two, three times. Trying to nearly knock out Sally. Now they need to get back into the ring because this is still count out. And DRIII gets, and now we're at six. DRIII with his little bounce. Sally said, oh, meet me out here. I'm gonna get this mother. I'm gonna make this a count out. You ain't gonna get a real pin against me. And now DRIII throws him into the turnbuckle. And then Sally escapes one more time. They both missed punches going the other way. Punch right back into his arm. He's gonna damage that arm so he doesn't get. Sally is 12-0. DRIII is 199-0. I can feel the ending coming for one of these men. And they have already faced off before, but not like this. Uh-oh. And Sally has DRIII laying in. Uh-oh. Clothesline on Sally. On DRIII. My mistake. Uh-oh. Here comes Sally. Flying through the sky is Sally. Sally's doing it again. I got a feeling that he's going to get the win. He's going to be undefeated at WrestleMania still. Believe that. Now Sally gets up. What is Sally doing? Sally flies outside the ring! And DRIII no-sells that and gets up. And he punches him in the jaw. Bam! Oh my god. Who's gonna come out? He's gonna try to get a submission outside the ring. He's trying to make him tap. Is he gonna tap? He taps. That's not it. That's not it. You can't do that outside the ring. And now Sally throws DRIII inside the ring. Holy crap. What a match. This is awesome. And I think this is it. Oh, he misses a kick into the chest. No. Oh, now he gets tossed into the. I'm surprised DRIII can do that. Uh-oh. He's about to go for the cash drop. If this is the cash drop, I think it's over. No, Sally says, fuck that. Get off me. And he's about to go for... Sally bomb! Holy shit! He has not done it in years. Here we go. One, two, three! It's over! Sally is our new WWE... K15 kicked out twice at the old school. And he gave us a Sally Bomb. We have not seen a Sally Bomb in years. He only uses it whenever he knows his opponent is so strong that he has to bring out his strongest attack. He didn't end this in a choke slam or a tombstone. He ended this, as we're going to see right here, in a Sally Bomb. No man has ever kicked and Sally has ended the streak of DR3. Oh my god. This is his first time being a WWE Undisputed Champion. He was WWE Champion before, but before we end up merging that title to the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. But congratulations, Sally. DR3 is now 9-1, and that is the man behind 1-199-1. And he is 13-0 at WrestleMania. Here he is, the best in the world, CM Punk, with his new yellow and white attire for WrestleMania. He's matching with our logo. That's pretty funny. He's been WWE World Heavyweight Champion and Survivor Series, yes. And he's going against his best friend or former best friend, MoneyGuy. He told him he was fake, as MoneyGuy said. He was going to stay on SmackDown for this championship. But CM Punk said in backstage, he told him he was going to Raw. So they both can hug it out like Chris Benoit and Eddie Guerrero. But it looks like they won't be doing that, as only one man tonight will be doing that. And guys, remember, WrestleMania and WWE, there's always a Hell in a Cell match. And we saved that for the main event. CM Punk, the World Heavyweight Champion, versus MoneyGuy the Challenger. Look out, he's showing it off to go to the fans. Will this be his last time seeing him? Oh, oh my god. His theme is back. Oh shit, holy fuck. MoneyGuy with his new green and black and white attire, with his old theme song back. Here comes the money. MoneyGuy is here. Here in Los Angeles. For this match, as he said, I am unstoppable. I'm undefeatable. And after WrestleMania, I am champion. And he has to defeat his best friend, CM Punk. And it was a good choice. I have faith in MoneyGuy defeating CM Punk. MoneyGuy will defeat CM Punk. As CM Punk called him fake. He called him fake. Here we go. This is unbelievable. It's like a Mountain Dew fight. Limit alive. The fans are getting ready. Here we go. And the ref is going to show them one more time. This is what you're fighting for. CM Punk fans in the crowd. We got MoneyGuy fans in the crowd. It is split 50-50. Who's going to come out champion here at WrestleMania Year 5? And as they stare each other down, two former best friends are going at it for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. This is our main event in a Hell in a Cell session of WWE WrestleMania Hell in a Cell match is our main event. As CM Punk comes in first, controlling the match, And they're going to lock up. The first lock up of the night and the only lock up, most likely. And there goes CM Punk. The technicals. Uh-oh. And they get back up and stare each other down. And there goes CM Punk with a suplex. And he's not going to go for a submission, as he's a submission specialist, CM Punk. He could put pain on you, boy. And he punches Money Guy in the jaw. And now he has him leaning on the ropes, and what he's going to do with the ropes. Has his legs on the ropes. Oh, shit. Good shit. CM Punk has the fans booing for that. The fans are behind Money Guy. Well, actually, no. He is 50-50. There's Punk heads and there's Money heads right now. And I'm digging this Money Guy new colors on this game with all green and black and white. And CM Punk changed this to yellow and white. What are you going to do? CM Punk is going. I think. Whoa! We thought he was going to go for the go to sleep, but then Money Guy reverses that. And then he was about to go for the stunner, but he didn't get to go through it. And CM Punk kicks him in the chest, in the stomach. And now he gets kicked in the back. There we go. Here we go. What's going to happen? Knee, bitch. And then he kicks Money Guy. CM Punk, no. Money Guy reverses that. And here we go with a super kick. Here we go. Come on. Pin him up. One, two. No, CM Punk kicks out. That was close. Here comes Money Guy with a big splash. 3-2. Splash on him, boy. And he's going for the pin. Come on. One, two. And there's another kick out by CM Punk. Now he gets jaw jacked once again. And now he almost got kicked in the back. And now Money Guy gets hit in the back and thrown on his back by CM Punk. And CM Punk is going to try to Irish whip him. No. Here comes Money Guy with a suplex. He's going to suplex him back into the ring. This is getting good. It's slowly building up. I can feel it. And here comes Money Guy. Here comes Money Guy. I think it's over with an F5. Click the button and CM Punk is busted wide open. He is busted wide open. One. Oh, he kicked out at one. That was not enough. And Money Guy, Irish whips Money Guy into the... Uh-oh. You know what time it is. Here comes CM Punk. Oh! With a flying elbow, tribute to Macho Man Randy Savage. And now he's going to go for the go to sleep. He's about to end it. It's 11 o'clock, kids. I think it's time for you to go to sleep. And Money Guy's busted wide open. Hey, Money Guy kicks out. Here we go. This is awesome right here. This is our main event in the Hell in a Cell. Money Guy, CM Punk. Now he throws into the pole. Now he's gonna kick him right into his chest. Money Guy right back onto CM Punk. Holy shit, what a match we're seeing right now. And Money Guy is going to splash. You know, he misses the splash. Now he gets kicked in the chest. Kicked in the chest again. Throwing it to the turnbuckle again. No, he kicks CM Punk in the chest. Now he's getting thrown down from the top turnbuckle. I don't know why he even tried to go up there. Now he's throwing it to another turnbuckle. I think he's trying to go for another elbow. See him on clothesline. Is he going to go for the pin? Yes, he is. You don't see him. Guy kicks out once again. And he rolls out the way. And another punch to the back of the head of CM Punk. Holy shit. And CM Punk, he's waiting for him. He wants to get outside. He's saying, come on, bring it out here. Click the button. We already see it. It's right to the left of the F4. It's an F5. To the right. No, he gets thrown into the cage. CM Punk, here we go. He's going to go for a suplex. They're going to get bricked. Oh, shit. Holy shit. Here we go. Suplex into the outside of the Hell in the Cell. They break the cage wide the hell open. We already know where they're trying to go. And Money Guy climbs up immediately. They want to go on top of this cage. They want to kill each other. That's what they want to do. And oh, almost suplex him off the top of the Hell in the Cell. They're on top of the cell, people. And CM Punk is missing all of his kicks. Both of these men are butt. Oh, it's getting very, very close to one of these men falling off of this. This ends careers. And here goes a suplex on top of the Hell in the Cell. This ends careers. This ends lives sometimes. Will this friendship go that far? There goes Money Guy. Tripping. What is going to happen on top of this Hell in the Cell? Now, what is Money Guy? Uh-oh, he's taking him to the edge. Here we go! Super kick! Right on, oh my god, did he break his neck? Did he break his neck? Super kick and CM Punk falls onto the announce table. Holy shit. It's, oh my god, leg drop into, oh my god. These two men won it all. Holy shit. A super kick into the announce table and then a leg drop from top of the hell in the Cell. And I am so surprised right now. CM Punk just got up. Now he punches Money Guy. Throws Money Guy's head into the Hell in the Cell cage. Holy shit. This is CM Punk. Now he tried to go for a roundhouse kick and CM Punk dodges that and punches him. Throws him right back into the Hell in the Cell. And he's gonna, oh, bust his nuts again. The place that AJ Lee loves. Punches Money Guy. These men are trying to do whatever they can to destroy each other. Amazing, and I'm surprised CM Punk is not dead. He landed on his neck. And Money Guy's like, no, bring it out here. We're gonna fight until the end of the night. And he throws him into the cage and body slams him. Now he's climbing to the top. Will he jump off again? No, CM Punk got up in time. CM Punk needs to get his neck checked. Uh-oh! Stunner! Stunner! And CM Punk is outside, inside the damn Hell in the Cell as he fell through. And Money Guy falls through. They're both laying there. Will this be a double count? No, they are still laying there. Who's going to get up first? Who's going to get that pinfall? Who's going to be WWE champ? They both rolled over at the same time. And here comes Money Guy. He's waiting for him to get up. For a super kick! Uh-oh. Now he's going for a King of Swing. Holy shit. Money Guy said he loves him, but he always does that. Fuck the fans. Fuck everybody. Fuck CM Punk. Fuck them all. Bam! You guys know what time it is. He's going for the spear. Money Guy spears the ref! He spears the ref! What? What? It's the ref! That doesn't make any sense. Money Guy spears the ref and now he's going back out to the outside of the Hell in the Cell. And a ref gets up, surprisingly. Money Guy speared the ref. Just how? Just why? In that point, I thought CM Punk and him were up to something, but I guess they're back on top of the Hell in the Cell. Will one of them go through it again? Holy shit, and CM, we got a bad camera angle. We're sorry. What the hell's going on up there? Who's going to go through? Money Guy or CM Punk? No. Not Money Guy. Here we go. Right to the F4. It's an F. Fuck. Not through the thing, though. Money Guy says, suck it, bitch. There you go. That'll be the last. It's right there. Oh, Money Guy falls through when he was showboating. Oh my god. Oh my god. And we'll see him Punk try to go for the go to sleep. Here we go. He's going for the Anaconda Vice. See him. Money Guy taps out. It's over. Holy shit. Money Guy.
Oh my god.
CM Punk defeats Money Guy. I cannot believe what just happened. Why the Money Guy speared a ref? We don't know. We will never know. But CM Punk is still WWA World Heavyweight Champion. What a match. And there you go, celebrating. I have no words for this. No words. CM Punk is still